Welcome to Medicine Unified. Today we are going to discuss a topic of gynecology called as uterine fibroids. Uterine fibroids, which are also called as leiomyomas or myomas, are the commonest benign tumor in the smooth muscles of uterus, and we see this tumor mostly in the women of reproductive age. So, uterine fibroids are the commonest benign tumors in the smooth muscles of the uterus in the women of reproductive age. It is also the most common pelvic tumor in females. The pathogenesis of the disease is yet not clear. There is a very much debatable topic about the pathogenesis. But as this fibroid regresses after menopause and it is very rarely seen before menarche, we call it as a estrogen progesterone dependent tumor. We can call it as an estrogen progesterone dependent tumor. So now let's talk about the locations of the fibroid. Fibroids can be extrauterine or intrauterine. If it is an extrauterine, the most common extrauterine site is cervix, and the second most common extrauterine site for fibroid is broad ligament. So this can be the questions in many exams, competitive exams. So locations, extrauterine locations of the fibroid are most commonly cervix, and second most common is broad ligament. Now let's talk about the fibroids, uterine fibroid, that is intrauterine fibroid. First one is intramural type. What happens? Intramural type means that suppose this is the uterus and these are the smooth muscles of uterus. So the intramural type is the fibroid which is located inside the muscle. Suppose this, mark it as 1. So this is the location of, this is the intramural fibroid. Second type is submucosal. Suppose there is a fibroid which is growing inwards towards the uterine cavity, like this one. It is going inwards towards the this is the uterine cavity. So if it is going inside towards the uterine cavity, we call it as a submucosal fibroid. Then the third one, that is subserosal. If the fibroid is going, instead of inward, that is like how we had in submucosal, if it is going outwards, that is towards the peritoneal cavity or outwards from the uterine cavity, we call it as a subserosal fibroid. Then we have some fibroids which lie on the peduncle or a stalk, suppose like this, on a peduncle, or outside like this. We call such fibroid as a pedunculated fibroid. Number 4 pedunculated fibroids. In this also we have two types. If it is going, once again, towards, if it is going inside towards the uterine cavity, we call it as a submucosal pedunculated. And if it is going outwards with the help of stalk, we call it as a subserosal pedunculated. So this was basic about the fibroid, that is its type, locations. Now we will discuss the epidemiology and symptoms, and after that how to treat the fibroids. Now we will discuss about the epidemiology. Uterine fibroids is most commonly seen in the women of reproductive age. That too, in the reproductive age women, and in women of age group 35 to 45 years, the incidence rate is approximately 40%. After this, uterine fibroids are most commonly seen in infertile nulliparous and black women. It is most commonly seen in infertile, nulliparous and black women, that is women of African race. Also, it is seen in obese females. The chances of getting fibroids in obese females is also very high. Now, if you are a relative of a fibroid patient, that is a first degree relative, that is from a daughter of a mother who is having a uterine fibroid, then your chances of getting fibroid increases 2.5 times. Then some systemic diseases like hypertension, diabetes, polycystic ovarian syndrome, this also increases the chance of getting fibroids. Now, what we discuss? Now we discuss about the symptoms. Usually, fibroids are asymptomatic. Most of the cases, the fibroids are asymptomatic. But if there is any symptom seen, the most common symptom seen is menorrhagia. That is, menstrual blood flow more than normal. That is menorrhagia. Then other symptoms which are seen are pelvic pressure or pain, discomfort in urination, urinary discomfort, constipation, backache or leg pain, so these are some of the symptoms which are seen in the patient of uterine fibroid. Mostly it is asymptomatic, but if we see any symptom, it will be one of them. So now let's talk about management, or we can call it as treatment. So we have a pharmacological options for treating fibroids, which only help in decreasing the size of fibroid, but in order to treat the fibroid, we'll always have to go for surgery. So first we'll just discuss the pharmacological drugs available to decrease the size of fibroid. We can give GnRH agonists, we can give uliprestin acetate, we can give danazole, and we can also give mifepristone. We can give these drugs, but eventually we'll have to go for a surgical management which will treat the disease, which will remove the disease, because this drugs will only help us to decrease the size of the fibroid. There are various surgical options available for fibroids, for the patients of fibroid, starting from hysterectomy, then we can go for myomectomy, or we can go for uterine artery embolization and the very new magnetic resonance guided focus ultrasound. So, surgical options. We'll discuss the surgical options. What are the surgical options available? Hysterectomy, that is removal of the uterus. We can go for myomectomy, that is removing the myoma, that is smooth muscles of the fibroid with the part of fibroid, in order to preserve the uterus, and we can have the patient can become pregnant in future. There are some new techniques, uterine artery embolization, in which what we'll do, we just put a catheter and we'll try to access the arteries which are supplying the fibroid, and after that what we do, we block those arteries using polyvinyl alcohol, putting through the catheter, and when it helps to decrease in the size of the fibroids, and the patient can be pregnant once again. Then the latest is magnetic resonance guided focus ultrasound surgery. This is also an available option. So we'll discuss which surgery should be done in which case. We have many cases, like asymptomatic patient, female is having a desire of pregnancy or not having a desire of pregnancy. So suppose first we have a patient of fibroid which is asymptomatic patient. So in this case what we'll do, we can give the drugs or we can just wait and keep her under supervision. If we have a patient who is in a postmenopausal state, we can do the treatment, but as we know this fibroids regresses after the menopause, so we'll also go for a supervision or wait for the fibroid to regress. Now if we have a patient who is having a desire of pregnancy, that is a patient who want to be pregnant, in this case we can go for myomectomy, that is we'll preserve the uterus and remove the part of the muscles with the fibroid. Chances of getting a normal pregnancy is 40 to 60% in this case, but yes, it is the only option if we want to have pregnancy. Another option, that is UAE, which I have already discussed what we do, this is still a questionable technique, because in some guidelines people say okay we can use it, in some they don't, so that's it. Then the last is patient with a high symptoms and no desire for pregnancy. In this case what we'll do, we'll go for hysterectomy, that is we'll remove the whole uterus, no organ, no problem. That kind of technique we use in order for the patient will have no desire for pregnancy. That was all about the surgical options. About diagnosis, if we go for complete blood analysis, we'll find the patient as anemic, hemoglobin level will be decreased. If we talk about the investigation of choice, it is ultrasonography or we can pelvic USG. So that was all about uterine fibroids. Thanks for watching my video. Please like, share and subscribe my channel, Medisimplified. Thank you.